Hi, my name is Leif Albertson. I work at the Cooperative Extension Service for the University of Alaska Fairbanks, and I'm out in Bethel today. I had some questions about the turf on the field here, and so I'm helping the city take some soil samples. We're going to send in and see if we can't help make the field a little bit greener this year. So since this is a really large area, we're going to take a number of samples. We'll probably do 5 samples today because we really want to get an idea of sort of what the average soil is like here. And once we do that and we have that sample, we're going to send it into a lab. They're going to look at the nutrients there, and they can make a recommendation that we can pass back to the city on how to improve the turf that they've got. So what I'm doing here is I'm going to take about 5 samples from around the field so we get a good sense of the average soil. We'll send that into the lab and they'll tell us about the nutrients. First thing I'm going to want to do here is make a D-shaped hole so I can get a nice slice of soil here. So we got a nice clean edge here, and I'm going to want to take about 1 inch off there. We don't need that much. Just going to try to take a nice sliver of soil there. Looks just like that. And then we're going to want to take about 1 inch column right in the middle. And for turf like this, we only need about the top 4 inches to do that. So like that, and like that, and then we have kind of a nice column of soil that should be a good subsample. And we're gonna take that and we're gonna put that in the bucket with our other samples. And eventually we'll mix them all together. I'm just using a hand trowel here. If the soil's real loose, you could use your fingers. Cut through that turf up top. And there you have a pretty good soil sample. What we're going to do next is mix up the subsamples that we've got into one sample. We want to mix everything in there really good. And we're going to start by, you know, we don't actually need the grass on top there. That'll just mess up our sample. But we're going to get in there and really mix it all together so that we got a good mixture of soil from the whole field. And I'm just using my hands for this and breaking up the soil clumps. There. Some organic matter on top, and it's okay. Roots and everything. But the thing to remember is that when they do take, they put the soil sample in the machine, it's actually just a very tiny amount. So we want to make sure that everything's mixed up really good. Otherwise, we might get a misleading sample. Or if we didn't take enough subsamples, we took a sample from a place that was sandier or wetter or you know, maybe had some runoff or something, it might give us misleading results. So we want like a really good mixture from all over our space. Okay, so we mixed up all our samples pretty good in this clean bucket. We don't want to use a dirty bucket because it could give us a misleading sample. And we're going to take about 1 pint of that soil. I'm going to put it in a plastic bag and take it back to the office where we'll dry it out.
A lot of the information that I got for this came straight out of our Cooperative Extension Soil Sampling publication. So if you can't remember it all, we've got this available online or from your local extension agent, and it lays it out pretty clearly. We're going to head back to our office now, and what we're going to need to do is dry the sample out. The soil laboratories like to get them dry. If they're wet, it can change the sample and give us results that won't be as good.
What I'm going to do when I'm done here is I'm going to clean this bucket out in case I need to use it for any other soil samples. I don't want to leave that dirt in there if I go sample from a garden or anything, because that might, you know, give misleading results to the people that are using the bucket after me for soil sampling. Okay, so we're back in the office, and the next thing we're going to do here is we're going to take our pint of soil that we mixed up here, and we're just going to let it dry. And we don't want to heat it up too much when we dry it, because that can change the chemistry of the soil. So we're just going to dry it at room temperature. I'm just putting it on a plastic tray here and spreading it out, and we'll just let it sit overnight and see how it looks tomorrow. Bust up some of these clumps. And if it looks dry tomorrow, we'll put it back in the bag and send it off to a soil lab. So one thing that's really important is that when we want to send our dried soil away in a bag, we want to really communicate with them where the soil came from, what we want to do with it, and so the most important thing is we have to label the bag, especially if we're sending in multiple samples, so that they don't just get a bag of dirt and not know what to do with it. A lot of labs will ask you specific questions, or they'll have something like a soil sample information sheet. They'll ask you what you're growing, what kind of amendments you've added or you might want to add. And you know, and that'll help them do the best they can with the sample that you set them and give you the best results, the most useful results they can. So once you have your soil sample and everything's labeled, you'll need to select a soil lab. There's places all over the country that do this, you know, whatever you want to choose is fine. After you send your sample in, you'll get soil sample results. And if you're not used to reading those, it can just look like a list of numbers. It might not make sense. So it's definitely a time where you can bring that into your cooperative extension agent, and they can help you interpret those results and give you some useful recommendations based on it. To add lime or to add nitrogen or a specific fertilizer, what to do to grow the best you can.
My name is Leif Albertson. I work for the Cooperative Extension Service through the University of Alaska Fairbanks. I hope these simple tips about soil sampling will help you, and if you have any questions about growing in your part of the state, you can contact your local district extension agent.